Kunal, thank you very much for speaking to us here on Game on ANN 7. We just saw you in a very, not very hectic training session. Of course, you had quite a difficult one yesterday. What does a training session entail?
Today, I'm just on a recovery session. I have one more week left before I leave for Morocco. I have the Continental Cup coming up next week. And it's my first time, and I will represent Africa there. I'm looking forward. And it's going to be a nice experience for me, and I'm just going to go out and I want to finish on the podium, and I'm just going to go out, do my best, and hopefully I will come out victorious.
Now you're having the absolute year of your life. Tell us a bit about your year in competition.
I had 6 races before the Commonwealth Games, and all my time showed that I'm in good shape. I went into the Commonwealth, my first Commonwealth Games, I was a bit nervous. I didn't know what to expect from the competition because Commonwealth Games is, for me, just as the World Championships and the Olympic Games, it's a big competition. I went out in the semi-finals as hard as I could. I qualified as the fastest runner for the day. And the following day, when I woke up, everything just felt different. I felt hungry. I felt today is going to be my day. I went out to the warm-up and I just told my coach, Coach, today I feel that I'm ready to go and no one is going to stop me today.
You changed your sort of the way you compete last year in 2013 with your coach Henny Kotze. Tell us a bit about that and how it's benefited your time.
Yeah, we identified a few areas, key areas last year. I missed the World Champs finals by one spot. I came 9th overall and only the top 8 can make it into the final. So it was a bit disappointing for me because since youth, 2007, I've always been in a final. Mm-hmm. The World Youth, the World Juniors, the World Students, and also my first championship seniors, I always made it into a final. So that was always something that I was proud of, that I can make the finals. But training changed a lot. We did a lot of endurance work, a lot of long stuff. So I think that helped a lot. Especially last week's race, my last race in the Diamond League in Zurich, I still managed to run my season's best, so it showed that I had a good base for the year. This year I just came out, as I said, fearless, and I just went out hard and the results paid off. And yeah, that's something I'm going to work on going forward, and hopefully I can bring more medals for South Africa.
Of course, the Continental Cup is taking place this weekend. What kind of competition are you expecting at the event?
There's 4 continents competing, and it's the top 2 of each continent that's competing against each other. And it's going to be tough. It's the same guys that I've competing against the whole season. So I'm looking forward to the challenge, and it's always nice racing against the best in the world, because that's how you can place yourself against the best guys in the world. So I'm just going to go out, and I think all of us, we're nervous for one another, so it's going to be a good race, and I think also fast times.
What are some of your future goals? What are you hoping to achieve?
Well, this year I achieved the African Championships, the Commonwealth Games. So going.
How do you top that?
So going forward, I think from next year, there's going to be a lot of pressure from the media, from the fans, and I think I'm ready for that challenge, and I'm ready for that pressure that the people are going to put on me, because that's how I want to measure myself against the best in the world. So going into next season, we have the World Championships coming up in Beijing next year, and that's going to be for me one of my big goals, because I would like to win a medal for South Africa. Obviously I'm going to train to win the gold medal. But I want to finish on that podium come the finals next season. So I just need to stay focused, hungry, and I just need to be ready for that big moment.
How much has your life changed since you won a medal at the Commonwealth Games and since you became the African champion? I mean, of course, you've been training hard over the years to get to that place, but how much has life changed?
It hasn't changed that much. Track and field is not that big in South Africa. I don't think a lot of people know about track and field. It's only the close family and friends that really are interested in track and field. But this season, South Africa had a good bunch of athletes performing at the Commonwealth Games and also the Africa Champs. So hopefully that will send out a positive message to South Africa and the wider community. And yeah, hopefully next season we can even perform better. And we would like to put track and field again on the map, because it's tough competing against football and rugby and cricket in South Africa. But I think the athletes competing at the moment, we enjoy what we do and we love track and field.
You're very positive about track and field and the amount of athletes that are coming through and doing well over this year. What are your aspirations for athletics as a whole at the Olympic Games and in the run-up to the Games?
I think Athletics South Africa must look after our athletes. I think we must start putting in more into our athletes, especially the coaches as well, because I think at the moment the athletes can compete on the world stage, but sometimes the coaches lack that experience of world standard. So I think South African athletics are in good hands at the moment. We have a good bunch of young athletes coming up. And building up for the Olympic Games, I think for my personally that South Africa can at least win 5 medals at the next Olympic Games. And if the guys stay focused and positive, then I think we can achieve that goal.
But are you worried at all that because of these Athletic South Africa boardroom battles, people are not getting into the sport and not coming in and being confident in actually having a future in athletics?
I think there are institutes, especially like the High Performance Center in Pretoria, and there's one opening now in Bloemfontein. And these people are busy identifying young talent around the country, and I think that's positive. Yeah, from my side, I'm also out there helping a few young athletes, even if it's just a motivational speech or a few words of encouragement. I think when I was a youngster, I was always looking up to athletes in Africa, especially Hester Kloete, Llewellyn Herbert. These were the top guys back in the days. And I think South Africa athletics, track and field, it's a beautiful sport. And I think if people can come and watch more track and field, I think the athletes will enjoy that and appreciate that and will even perform better.
Kunal, thank you very much. And we enjoy watching you run and we'll definitely be watching you at the Continental Cup.
Thank you very much.